Well, on Daily Business Edition, we talk about different issues, but now we have something that you will love. We have gold. Gold returned from United Kingdom, from Bank of Anglia to Poland, and that was a major logistical operation unveiled only a few days ago because it was top secret. Adam Glapiński, the chairman of Polish National Bank, made himself a picture with a piece of gold in front of the National Bank of Poland vault. Marcin Roszkowski of Jagiellonian Institute is our guest tonight, sir.
Thank you for having me.
Have you ever been in the vault of National Bank of Poland?
Of course, I've been working in the central bank for over years. I've been in the vault of Polish Central Bank. I've also been working for the central bank for over years. So generally, yes, it's not a secret that there are gold bars in Polish national bars in Polish National Bank. But generally, the initiative to bring the gold back from the Bank of England and also to buy more gold on the market, I think it's a good approach. There is a slowdown threatening also Polish economy. Gold is always a turning commodity. Commodity people turn to when the slowdown or crisis is ahead. So it's a reasonable decision of the Polish
central bank.
Some
people discuss it, how sensible it is in a situation when our currency, as many others, is a fiduciary. We believe in its value while the value is distributed among businesses, among real estates, and so on. So
yes, gold is just a token. But generally, the value you have mentioned is also measured by the credibility of the central bank. And the central bank assets also include gold. So generally, and our other of course, other currencies. But generally, it makes the situation of Polish, improve the situation of Polish central bank.
During this upcoming slowdown, we will be more secure. How probable is that slowdown?
I think we can see it. The PMI index in Germany, also the PMI index in Poland, shows that a slowdown is there. Something went wrong with the German economy. It's growing about 0.5% annually, so actually something is broken there. The good news for Poland is that it's not influencing Poland as much, and as you can, as you know, Germany is one of the Polish major partners, economic partners.
So generally, something is rotten in the state of Germany, but fortunately in Poland not so much.
For the time being, it's not influencing Poland as much. The slowdown is there. Also, politicians are mentioning it. The problem we could witness is that most of the social or demographic programs in Poland are also based on the growth of Polish GDP. But when it's growing 3.5, 4.5%, it's generally, anyways, it's a record in the European Union. So generally, we are on the safe side for the time being, of course, because the situation can change. But it consists of actually two things. Poles work very hard, and also the policies, the governmental policies are not hurting, not all the governmental policies are hurting the economy.
The governmental policy is to stimulate growth. That's the official aim that Law and Justice, the ruling party, is stating since its first term in 2005-2007. Then they come up with this growing the economic growth strategy, with this social strategy to manage, make this growth, to manage the profits of this growth.
Actually,
affect whole society rather than selected few.
Just in couple of sentences, how to describe the situation. The Law and Justice Party has changed the approach to the budget and its redistribution policy, and it's the redistribution of the budgetary funds. It's quite it's being spread to the most of Polish society, not only too few. So generally, the consumption part of the GDP is at a high level. The problem that we are facing, that the government is trying to influence and improve, is the investment part of the GDP. There is still room for investment opportunities and investment growth, which actually can help us during the slowdown period.
This is actually a standard policy that's being carried out by the governments of Germany and Scandinavian countries for years with very good results. And yet, in Poland, it makes some discussions that people want to provide more market-oriented policy.
I think it's a good time to concentrate on other policies than the social and demographic, to provide incentives for the small and medium businesses to help ease some of the bureaucratic boundaries. And I think this is a time to a bit verify the approach.
Well, there's lots of issues here, like, for example, investment in the new technologies, like R&D spending, rising the level of Polish university that are somewhere in the second part of the first thousands in the world. So that's way below our aspirations. And do you think that with the slowing in economy, the law and justice will have a time to address these issues?
I think so. There are certain sectors of Polish economy that need to be improved. Some of them are state-controlled, or this influence of state companies is huge. I think the energy transformation also, you mentioned the reform of Polish universities. During the expose, Prime Minister Morawiecki addressed some of the issues for medium and small companies. For example, an Estonian tax that could be so the tax can be prolonged to the period when the dividend is paid out. So there are some instruments that the Polish government can put on the table. Let's see what will happen during the first 100 days. Right. Unfortunately, there is one issue we need to take under control, under consideration, is the May elections of the May elections of the president. So generally, yeah, the situation is dynamic, and for the time being, we are developing pretty fast, and we are doing better than our neighbors.
And that's good information. Marcin Roszkowski of Jagiellonian Institute, sir, thank you very much.
Thank you.
And that was it for tonight's Poland Daily Business.